Welcome back to United Tradesman Academy. This video is sponsored by ICM Controls. For us electricians that follow the National Electrical Code, well, in 2020, Article 230.67, a new code came out requiring all services supplying dwelling units to be provided with a surge protective device, SPD. The SPD, surge protective device, must be a type 1 or type 2 device. This is a type 1 and a type 2 device. It serves appliances, electrical, HVAC, pool, and spa. This is the ICM 518 model. One of the best parts about it is that it's made in the USA. Another cool feature that I like is that you can scan this barcode here, which I'll do shortly here, and you'll be provided with more cool information. On the back of it, it just shows the specs of the device. One of the most important devices is the short circuit current rating, which is rated for 200,000, and the KA, which is rated for 20,000. And they have other models for three-phase applications and for some other applications also. Let's get to the unboxing of this. So this is a rain tight weatherproof NEMA 4X enclosure. So this is rated for indoor and outdoor. What I like the most, or what's high on my list, is they include a waterproof ring gasket that will prevent water from getting in to your electrical panel. Very nice construction. Okay, so what else is included in the box is your instructions. Also, you can scan this to get rewards. Contractors, use the ICM Controls app to scan this barcode. And it just has a few instructions down below. Now let's scan that barcode on top. So this is the ICM Controls website. Just get more product information, lifetime protection warranty, download for the instructions again, sell sheet, and warranty information. And you can go down and find the distributor, or you can also, let's see how much this product costs. So right now the product is listed for $73, $74. This is by far one of the best products that you can get for your home. Once again, this is the ICM 518. Let's go ahead and get to the install portion of this video. Okay, so first thing you need to do is locate where your electrical panel is inside of your home. It could be in your garage, or it could be in your clothes closet. Once you have located it, we need to locate your main breaker. One easy way to find out where your main breaker is, it'll be the very large one. So some of them say 100 amp, some say 125, this one says 150, and some of them even say 200 amps. So now that we have located where the main breaker is, let's turn that off. Now that breaker is in the off position, killing the power that's being distributed throughout the other breakers. We need to locate where we want to actually install the surge protector at. You can install it on the sides. You can install it on the bottom. You can even install it on the top. It all depends on where you want to install it and where you have space at. So for this particular installation, we're going to be installing it down low. Now, I'm going to do a mock test or a mock fitment to see where this is going to be located upon completion. So I just want to bring it down low and kind of line it up with some of the holes here to see which suits best for my needs. So right now it's over this hole right here, which is probably which one I'm going to go with, but let's try this hole right here. I think I like that hole much better, so we're going to go with this hole right here. So we need to knock this 3/4 and 1/2 inch punch out right here. Simple as that. Next part, grab hold of your wires, slide them up through that hole. This is just for a test fit. So you see how that goes? Just like that. Okay. So I'm gonna slide one of the lock rings down. Slide it all the way down. Now this weatherproof ring here is going to go on the top side. Like that. Slide the last ring down over. Now we're ready for the next part of the installation. Okay, last but not least, what I love about the ICM 518 model is that it can be wired up as type 1 or type 2. So for this particular installation, we're going to be wiring up for type 2, which means we'll use a double pole breaker. So to make it short, simple, these two black wires will go onto this double pole breaker. One wire will go underneath one screw. The other wire will go underneath the other screw. And this white wire will go on the neutral bar. You see where I have this white tape? Well, the white tape identifies with this white neutral wire that's coming off of the SPD. So once again, two blacks go to the breaker. One white matches up with the white on the neutral bar. Simple as that. So now let's get going. Does not matter which wire goes first. Once you get it screwed down, just give it a slight tug, just to make sure it's in there. Same thing with that neutral, just give it a slight tug, okay? Give it a slight tug. That completes the installation for the ICM 518 surge protective device. Now you're ready to turn your power back on. Okay, so this is the last part of the video here. You are ready to turn your main breaker back on that you turned off. Main breaker is back on. Now we are ready to turn on the breaker that we hooked the surge protector device to. My particular breaker right here that's serving the SPD is hooked onto a 50 amp double pole breaker. Once I turn it on, you'll see a green light that says protected when lit. That's how you know you have your SPD device hooked up correctly. Green light is on. Protection when lit. That's how you know that you have successfully installed the ICM 518 surge protective device. You will not find a better surge protective device for the price, for the amount of protection that you get, and for the price point. It's by far the cheapest out of all of them. And the entire product is made in America. Where else are you going to find that at? Not too many places. Hey guys, so look, if you want to learn more about the surge protect device here, this is the ICM 518. So go to ICM.com and search 518 and it'll give you even more information on it. Guys, thank you for watching. I hope you liked the video. Stay tuned. We'll see you guys next time.